Well, good morning. There we are.
Yeah, there we are.
We are live here in Des Moines, Iowa. It is day two of the first ever Division II tournament in Des Moines, Iowa, here at Hy-Vee Arena. And we are getting ready to start things off with our consolation bracket. My name is Magilla Gorilla. Good morning, everybody. Hope you got your coffee. I am joined by Stunt Rocker. He is going to have the coolest shirt ever to help wake you up in the morning with beautiful bright colors. He's lovely. I may watch this as the bout goes on, too. I'll let you take over. Yesterday featured a lot of upsets, a lot of excitement in the first round. Darling of the tournament, Treasure Valley, goes to the semifinals today. But we start things off this morning with the consolation bracket. Excuse me. And that is going to pit our number seven seed, Omaha, who lost to Treasure Valley yesterday.
Ran into that buzzsaw that is Treasure Valley.
That's right. They did. We're not quite sure about if they're for real or not. We're going to find out, I think today. And they're going to be playing D.C. D.C. Roller Girls, the number four seed. They lost a heartbreaker to Jet City. Really all about penalties for that. Jet City had 10 trips to the penalty box with their jammers alone, and that is not something you can recover from. We are going to be starting off here very shortly, and I tell you what, we're going to have Stunt Rocker here talk about the rosters, who's going to be skating today for both squads.
We've got Whips and Pains, Badass Maggie, Lenore Gore, Akutra Payne, Dual Hitizen, Lois Slane, Frightmare, Maiden Samarkon? Right and Dirty, Bruise Hilda, Sharp Shredder, Velocity Raptor, Spank Aaron, and Jersey Hill for the DC Roller Girls. And for Omaha, we've got Sharon Misery, Forbid and Fruit, Makilia, Texas Viper, Holmes Sweet Holmes, Midlife Crashes, Make It Rain, Axel Rogue, Daisy Mayhem, Danail, Enya Coffin, Rady Ruck, Anti-Embolism, Skate Away Faye, and Molly Massacre.
Thank you so much for that. We are going to start this off here. This is the first of our, like I said, of our consolation bracket. We'll see some consolation work this morning to start off. In the afternoon, you will see the semifinal matches between the teams that advanced yesterday. Starting us off today in the red will be the DC Roller Girls. You can see them lining up at the Zombie Burger Jammer line. And our first jammer for DC will be number 85, Jersey Jill. Going against Omaha, they'll be wearing the, we're going to call it Olive this morning. That's Olive.
I believe that is Olive.
If the folks want on hashtag WFTDTV want to tell us it's a different color, we'd love to know that. Jamming for Omaha is Midlife Crashes, number 39. And we are underway here for day two. Number 85 for DC pushes to the very front of the Omaha wall. Two-woman wall right now. There's a bridge there for Omaha. Lead jam awarded to DC already. Nice start there, Stunt Rocker, for the ladies in red.
They are jumping out right up front. Midlife Crash is really getting controlled in the pack as I say this, as she breaks free.
Well, that's the announcer curse, my friend. Once you say something, the opposite happens. This is the first scoring pass here for Jersey Jill of DC, and she's trying to work through a front wall of three Omaha skaters. Solid front wall there. If she can get past them, she can call the jam off, but look at Omaha tries to get a little points action. There's nothing at the end. 2 points for DC to start things off, so we're off the Schneid. DC with a 2-0 run, Stunt Rocker.
Omaha really kind of having a loose wall in there. One of their skaters getting stuck in the back. Another one having to bridge as they kind of got too far out in front of the pack.
And then DC will be lining up on the Zombie Burger jammer line with their jammer. Frightmare, 31M, going up against 4-0-2, Make It Rain for Omaha. Tight scrum start. Same issue as before. Looks like DC's content to push front and use their four-man wall to hold back Omaha. Two skaters for Omaha try to hold back DC's jammer. Can't do it. Lead jam goes to DC.
Omaha once again getting spread out up the front of the pack.
Yeah, right now it looks like DC's quite content to have that back wall really dominate. They did lose a blocker there to a penalty. Low block assessed there to number 42, Axel Rogue for Omaha, and a five-point grand slam on the board for DC. So early 7-0 lead for DC, the ladies in red. Second scoring pass here for Frightmare. She gets through. Only two blockers out there for Omaha. Calls the jam off. She's awarded four more points, so a nine-point jam. And already we see Omaha down early. They ran into that buzzsaw yesterday of Treasure Valley. We're going to find out, was it about Treasure Valley or was it about Omaha, Stunt Rocker?
Or was it a little bit of both?
Yes, that could be the case. The middle ground. Taking the jam line for DC is Sharp Shredder. Go ahead, sir. I'm sorry.
We're all looking forward to see Treasure Valley play a little more. But Omaha, really, after having been, with the past two or three years, in the Division Ones, now in the Division Two, and having a little bit of trouble so far here today, although...
Yeah, see, you're gonna be the blessing for Omaha. Brady Rock, the jammer for Omaha's blast right past that DC wall, gets lead jam very easily. And right now it looks like Sharp Shredder is being held back and held in check just a little bit by the two blockers for Omaha. Omaha loses another blocker, but it has to be recycled back in because the penalty box is already full. That is the notorious RED penalty box, already full of two Omaha skaters. First scoring a chance here for Omaha. Brady Ruck is trying to get past DC, does so, calls the jams off. Finally, no points there for DC, but four on the board, and Omaha is off the schneid, Stunt Rocker. So already the penalty box being filled up by both squads, just a tinge. Looks like Omaha having more trouble than the fine folks in DC. We will see taking the jam line for DC in red. That is Frightmare once again, her second jam here this bout. She goes up against number 630 for Skateaway Faye for Omaha. Oh my gosh, quick start there, quick lead jam, but followed back behind her real fast. It's Omaha's jammer as well. It is a quad race. They are zipping around very quickly. Is this going to be an attempt to get a couple points, hit it and quit it by DC? Goes in, falls down, gets knocked down. Omaha's jammer makes it all the way through.
Skateaway Faye is one of their newer jammers. She's just coming to the All-Star team this year, but she's obviously become a little bit of a spark plug for them.
Skateaway Faye, great effort there. Gets 4 points, forces DC to actually continue the jam a little bit longer than they wanted to because it looked like they were going to try to get through and get points and call it off, but they didn't. Both sides get four. That makes the score 15-8 in favor of DC. Omaha's trying to get their pack back together. It looks like they've got three skaters out there right now. For Omaha, taking the jam line is number 39, Midlife Crashes, her second jam of this bout. She goes up against, looks like Jersey Jill for DC.
That is.
Jersey Jill trying to push up against that Omaha wall. Same situation as before. We see Omaha setting up to the front. We see DC setting up to the back. Pushing is Jersey Jill. She tries to fight past those walls. Can't get clear. One blocker to beat. Does so. Lead jam goes to DC.
Really having some success pushing her out of bounds. And Midlife Crashes headed for the penalty box. That's going to hurt Omaha.
This is a power jam here. First power jam of the bout. We've got four Jersey Jill, lone jammer out there. And she finishes her first scoring pass. Five in the sky. Grand Slam awarded here to DC. So DC trying to flip the script from yesterday. Yesterday they could not keep their jammer on the track. They want to see if they can tighten that up. There's still a lot to play for in this consolation round. Winner of this bout gets another bout today, so it's a long day for these folks. Second scoring pass here for Jersey Jill. 5 points to the board. What's going on with those blockers for DC there, Stunt Rocker? Are they playing passive? Or?
They're playing a little bit passive. They're looking to pull it. They're just looking to stay on the side and just sort of screen out the opponents, but that's causing Omaha to have to play off of that passive offense. About they're giving away two or three feet before the jammer even gets to them.
Third scoring pass here, 15 points to the board. This will be the fourth scoring pass, I believe. So that is going to be another 5 points. Jam is called off. That is a monster 20-point jam for Jersey Jill. So they take advantage of the power jam and really punish Omaha. Now up 35-8, and Omaha is already looking for answers. With about 24 minutes to go here in the first half. And
really,
go ahead.
Punishing her, even when Omaha had what has been historically their most effective tandem, Sharon Misery
the other one.
Yeah, the other one who I'm actually friends with.
Frightmare is on the jam line and for DC, no jammer for Omaha. Three-woman wall at the front there. Power jam does come to a close as number 39 returns to the track. Midlife Crashes. Lead jam goes to DC, Frightmare. So like we see this a lot now, Stun Rocker, we see on these power jams the teams try to call the jam off just in time to get one more chance to win the next jam, and that's exactly what happens here.
Exactly.
4 points on the board there for Frightmare. She does call the jam off. You'll hit it and quit it. So the lead will now be extended now.
Grab
DC.
Grab that lead jammer before the other jammer can even get onto the track.
We will see jamming on this jam for DC. Lenore Gore goes up against Rady Ruck. Rady Ruck wearing the olive black pants. Lenore Gore wearing the red black pants for DC.
Luckily, we all get black pants.
Yes.
We'd also like to thank Cheeseball Bearings. Check out the Cheeseball Bearings Bracket Bonanza. Make sure you fill out your bracket for the Kalamazoo D2 playoffs coming up. You can't get in them for the D1, the Des Moines ones, obviously. We've already playing.
Lenore Gore gets lead jam for DC, but is not able to get out of the pack. Omaha's wall tightens up strongly. Randy Ruck got out very quickly and forced the issue. Jam called off, no points on the board, so no damage done. Good defensive effort there by Omaha to slow down the damage. They need a little run here, but they will take any positive jam they can get. Already down by 31. Taking the jam line for Omaha is Make It Rain. Goes up against 606. Sharp Shredder for DC. DC sends out dual citizen Akutrapain, Whips and Pains, and Riding Dirty to block for her.
Sharp Shredder looking for that inside line.
Doesn't find it. Omaha sends her inside and punches her. Looks like the packs are spread out. A chance for Omaha to get lead jam, but she is edged out there in turn two. Has to reset herself back into the pack. It looks like it was a penalty, though, and lead jam goes to Omaha.
That was a fortunate penalty for her.
Yes, it was. That is Whips and Pains will be taking a trip to the notorious RED penalty box. Omaha comes around for their scoring pass on this jam, and they do need it. They don't want to get down early to DC. Jam is called off there in a scrum before turn one and two. 3 points on the board for Omaha, no points on the board for DC, so Omaha ends this streak. What do they need to do to continue to work on DC, Stunrocker?
Well, it looks like they need to just keep that wall together. Yeah. They're getting spread out in the front. Now they're seeing that they're trying to take the back, make DC take the front so they can get pushed forward by that jammer, by Skateaway Faye in this case.
And they like that. It looks like they like to see that DC was doing that. We're going to try too. Wait a minute. They're going somewhere foreign here, folks. They're going up to a different part. What part of the track is that, Stunrocker?
I believe they call that the pivot line.
The pivot line?
Oh, pivot line. That's right.
Omaha's,
now I remember.
Omaha's jammer, Skateaway Faye, is able to get out and get lead jam. So the attempt by DC to switch up tactics and go to the pivot line does not work out. Lead jam goes to Omaha. Jammer does get out, number 85. That is Jersey Jill for DC. Omaha on a scoring pass. Only two blockers out there. It looks like they're going to lose one more blocker. Jam is going to be called off. Touching hips. There is Omaha. 4 points on the board. So quick little run. Quick little run there for Omaha. They've had two positive jams, Stunrocker.
Well, yes, and you know, from what I'm seeing, Skateaway Faye really has been their most overall effective jammer. She's gotten lead jam a couple times when the other ones have got some of the other jammers have gotten stuck back in the pack. She seems to be the nice replacement for the coach now. You saw over there. I'm a fire starter who had been their real go-to jammer before.
First jam of the bout here, excuse me, not first jam of the bout at all. That was Frightmare jamming, actually, for DC. She's listed as the wrong jammer here in my little sheet. I apologize. She goes through the Omaha pack without much trouble, looks at the bench, calls it off. 4 points to the board for DC. So they end this short little run there, this little seven-point run by Omaha. And answer back now up 43-15 with about 19 minutes and some change to go left in this one. Yeah, Omaha seems to perform much better on the track when they got all their blockers out there and they can communicate. But right now, we have ourselves a whole bunch of girls visiting the notorious RED penalty box. Two skaters standing for DC right now. Lenore Gore jamming for the ladies in red against Rady Ruck. Ladies in olive, that is Omaha. Omaha with two blockers. DC with just one, and Rady Ruck says, forget it, I got this. Lead jam goes to Omaha.
She took right advantage of that, shot up that inside seam.
But there's not enough blockers out there to slow down Lenore Gore either. The pack is completely spread out. It is mayhem. Omaha's got three blockers. They're going to try to assemble things, slow it down, and allow themselves to grab a blocker or two and get their jammer some points. Jammer does enter the back of the pack and is able to get 3 points. So Omaha gets back on the board, and Omaha is content to not look at this score, Stunrocker, in panic.
No, they are, as I said, they've been to the D1 playoffs, yep, several times in a row. They've got Daisy Mayhem out there and Sharon Misery and several other players who've done this many times. They've been in the tournaments. They've got the veteran. They've got the veterans with the experience to know, don't panic.
That's right.
Just keep playing your game. They seem to be wanting to speed up the pack, actually.
Well, try some stuff out. You know, this is a chance to experiment here. Jersey Jill on the line for DC. Goes up against 4-0-2. And that is Make It Rain. Looks like we have ourselves a penalty, though, and a back block is called against Jersey Jill, so this is going to be a power jam for Make It Rain.
She just shoved her way through there and incurred a back block while she was doing it.
And Omaha has all four blockers on the track against two DC blockers. Unfortunately, Make It Rain gets sent down.
It looked like Daisy Mayhem was trying to clear a path on the outside. Make It Rain took the inside and got stuck.
Make it rain seen enough, but she calls the jam off. Excellent effort there by the two blockers out there. Dual Hiddison and Spank Aaron. They went ahead and took care of business down two blockers. And I think Omaha decided, you know what? Let's just start this again.
We set this.
I don't like how that was looking. Let's make this happen all over again.
Hit the reset button.
Hit the reset. Skateaway Faye will take the jam line for Omaha. And you mentioned it, Stun Rocker. Skateaway Faye looks pretty strong this morning.
She's looking very strong this morning. You know, I got to see her play against my hometown Derby Dames about a month and a half ago. And honestly, I don't remember her looking this strong then.
Lead jam goes to her. She's able to work through that front two wall, which now becomes a three wall for DC. Siren Misery, Texas Viper, Daisy Mayhem, and Molly Masker for Omaha out there trying to slow things down. They're bridging themselves to try to extend the pack out. Little edge out there, though, by the blockers from DC to send a recycled skater back to the back. She's going to have to try it again. Omaha's trying to play a little passive-aggressive here, I guess, is what we'd like to call it, huh, Stunt Rocker?
That is a formidable wall out there.
Yes, there's a lot of strength out there.
I wouldn't want to get hit by
him. No. 5-point grand slam for Omaha as Omaha tries to get back into this one and cut down the lead. Omaha loses the blocker, though, to penalty. And an inside move there by Skateaway Faye, untouched. 5 more on the board, 10-point jam, and the power jam comes to a close. But it looks like a legal procedure penalty called against Jersey Jill, drawn by the blockers of Omaha. So a power jam will start up again. Skateaway Faye, I don't think she quite knew that had happened there, Stunt Rocker.
She just called it. I'm not sure she knew that was going on. But, hey, that's another – that essentially just continues this power jam.
Well, and D.C., the story of yesterday for D.C. was their jammers couldn't stay on the track. Now, they started off really nicely here against Omaha, but we're seeing a little bit of the same thing. A couple power jams here already. I think this is at least the third or fourth power jam. And that's not what DC's victory path is going to be here. Omaha will send up number 39. That is Midlife Crashes.
They go from one of their newer jammers to one of their veteran jammers.
Midlife Crashes is definitely a name that would indicate veteran status, I believe.
Yes.
to be polite. She's able to use her physical strength to get through, gets lead jam. Good news for DC, all four blockers out there. Dual Hiddison, Ride and Dirty, Bruce Hilda, and Velocity Raptor. So there's a chance for them to at least do a little damage here, trying to slow this power jam down. This is the second jam. That is a power jam.
Wow, four. DC doing a very good job on that penalty kill.
They're killing time, jam down to about a minute 20, with 5 more points to the board, and we are approaching a very dangerous zone here for DC, as now Omaha's only down by 6.
That's really all you can do on a penalty jam is just try to kill time.
Fired up fans, fired up skater. 5 more points, 15-point jam. Jam is called off, and we have drawn within 1.
1 point.
Ah, yes. The consolation bracket is living up to all expectations, my friend, as we have a little bit of drama on our hands.
It is living up to the entire thing that we've seen this entire tournament.
Yes.
It's anybody's game at any moment. It can turn over. It can change. There are no givens.
Smart play by Omaha. Called the jam off with plenty of time to reset. And while the jammer, Jersey Jill, stands in the penalty box for DC, they're going to send out Rady Ruck is Omaha, the lone jammer. And she's going to bruise up against that 4-1 wall of DC. Just battling her way through. Holds on the outside. Shrugs off the hit. Gets called lead jam, but she's got some work to do still. Takes a shoulder shot there from DC's blocker.
Meanwhile, Jersey Jill just sort of works her way through the pack.
Well, kudos to Badass Maggie for DC because she laid the last hit on Rady Ruck that sent her out and forced the jam to be called off too soon because Jersey Jill snuck in, like you said, like a thief of the night, entered into the play without anyone really being aware of it. No damage done there on that jam. Make It Rain will take the jam line this morning for Omaha. She has eaten her Wheaties today, my friend. She got up this morning, had a power breakfast and a big cup of coffee because she is playing some tough derby today. She may have even had some Derbalife.
Yeah, maybe she had some Liftoff, the official drink of the Des Moines, or the
Of
the announcers of the WFDBA Division II tournament here in Des Moines.
Lenora Gore pushing the front there, trying to get past the pivot of Omaha. Does get lead jam, so DC tries to respond. Does get the lead jammer. Unfortunately, hot on her trail is Make It Rain, full of Derbalife. She is pumped up this morning.
That,
Go ahead, bud.
That outside arm swinging.
Lenore Gore hits the pack. Pack's moving very quickly. Gets 2 points out of it, but nice job of non-lead jam points goes to make it rain. She is able to get 1 point. That keeps this tight bout just as tight. Folks, if you're enjoying this action, I tell you what, it has been an incredible weekend already. We got more to come. WFTDA TV. You can check out /passes. Check it out. There's a button there that you can donate to Stunt Rocker. If you like what you're seeing, because this is all free this weekend. It's going to be free next weekend for the second round of D2. Donate a little bit if you're enjoying the show, if you're enjoying the presentation.
It's the only way we're paying for these two tournaments.
Give a little.
Is drop something in the virtual tip cup.
Frightmare pushes the front of the Omaha wall. Omaha stout defense right now at the back of the pack for Omaha. Is Skateaway Faye. Lead jam goes to D.C., so good response here. Good energy from D.C.'s walls, Stunt Rocker.
Skateaway Faye through on her initial pass.
First scoring pass here for Frightmare. Two Omaha blockers stand at the front, slowing her down, trying to keep her from getting any further. Finally, she fights her way through, calls the jam off as Skateaway was approaching the pack. 4 points, so a little breathing room from D.C. They take that deep breath, and they try to reassess after those big power jams that they gave up.
They're still only up by 6, and that's really, that's nothing.
But they need to breathe. They need to breathe. They need to get relaxed, get your rhythm back.
Get that feeling of we can, okay, no.
They're having the post-stress trauma from yesterday. They got to get over it. They can't go back to the penalty box like they did yesterday.
No.
Number 39 on the line for Omaha. Jersey Jill out there for D.C.
Well, looking over at the penalties, it looks like Omaha is actually having more problems with penalties.
Well, you know, the one thing, lead jam there goes to D.C.'s Jersey Jill. So we've seen 3 jams in a row, 3 lead jams for the ladies in red. Penalties a bit of an issue here for neither side. I mean, for both sides, they both have 1 skater out in the box.
Midnight Crash is holding her nose as she's going around. I don't know if...
Yeah, hopefully she's okay. Maybe she took a little shot there, an inadvertent shot. Jersey Jill gets sent out there, which he turned 1-2, was only able to get 3 points, but she takes it. She calls the jam off. You talked about penalty, Stunt Rocker. Yesterday, the problem with the penalties with DC was that they were stacked. You know, it's okay if you have a lot of penalties as long as you can spread it out across your whole team.
Exactly.
But if you get them focused and get them in bad timing, it gets ugly.
Well,
and
jammer penalties are just, they're so deadly.
Well, with passive offense right now, the way it works, you can really give up a lot of points very quickly. Ready Ruck, number 777, takes the jam line for Omaha. She will go up against number 29, Jewel Hiddison. This is Jewel Hiddison's first jam of this bout. And she does it very nicely, gets lead jam on the outside very quickly. Jewel Hiddison, obviously.
Ready Ruck still stuck through.
Finally gets through. DC loses 1 more blocker. Omaha's got 3 blockers in front of Jewel Hiddison. And they edge her out. She gets recycled back to the back of the pack and gets pulverized again there in turn 4 and says, enough of that.
That's Molly Massacre just dropping the bomb on her.
Molly Massacre. Massacre Jewel Hiddison. She calls the jam off. 2 points to the board for DC. They are responded nicely. They've kept their cool, and they're not getting big jams, but they're getting positive jams. They're trying to get a little bit more arm's length away from
just
Omaha.
Doing 4 points and out, four or 5 points out.
Yeah, 2 or 3, whatever that you can get. You get what you get here.
Exactly. And then call it because it's just the point differential they're going for.
Lois Slane.
Oh, wow.
Wow, quickly off the jam line, number 402.
Make it rain.
Make it rain. Says, I'm going to make it rain on this jam. I'm going to get some points. And she gets through very quickly.
Very opportunistic of seeing that open thing. And once again, gets through untouched.
Frightmare, the jammer for DC, cannot get past the Omaha wall. Great job there by Forbidden Fruit.
And this is that fast pack that Omaha seems to be doing very well with.
I know. Denalia Coffin, Axel Rose, Forbidden Fruit. They are holding back this jammer, and this is another scoring pass possibility here for Make It Rain. This is a 5 points on the board already for Omaha, and Omaha looks for more. Muslin pass, the pivot, Make It Rain, another scoring pass, and Frightmare still at the back of the pack. This is a 10-point jam, and we have ourselves a 1-point bout just like that. Lightning strike offense, easy for me to say, for Omaha. Omaha goes on a 3rd scoring run. And if they get this completed, they can, and they do so, and the jam will be called off, and the Omaha fans are going crazy
that
in the stands.
wonderful 14-point run. You normally think of Omaha as a slow-it-down, big-hitting team, but they are doing very well.
15 points, Dunrocker. Sorry to cut you off. 15-point even-strength jam for Omaha, and they have taken a 4-point lead. 7:32 left to go here in the first half.
I believe this is a lead change.
Timeout on the track. Looks like it's a D.C. timeout.
We'd like to thank Rydell, the official skate of the WFTDA, unmatched quality, unmatched performance, as well as Adam Wheels, a proud partner and the official wheel of the WFTDA, and the wheels I actually skate myself.
You skate on them. That's great. Good for you.
They're good wheels. Why wouldn't I?
So if you have a chance to donate on WFTD.TV/passes, that's great. We would appreciate that. But you know what? There's other stuff going on there, too. Because we're talking about the postseason. We're talking about Division I, my friend. Division I postseason is coming up shortly. We've got Division II right now and next week. And beyond that, you will have to think about what you're going to pay to watch the Derby, because it's going to be quality, top-notch Division I Derby, some of the most exciting Derby we've ever seen in the women's field. You have a chance to buy passes for $12 for one playoff weekend, $20 for the championships, or for $50 the entire all-encompassing pass for the entire tournament. Until August 26th, if you sign up, it's just $45.
I know I'm getting it.
You ought to.
There's no reason not to.
You're crazy. It's going to be the best Derby you've ever seen. Lenore Gore will take the jam line for D.C. They had a timeout. It was time to take a breather and talk about it. They had a tough jam on that one. Even strength, giving up 15 points. Countering this on the jam line will be Skateaway Faye. Omaha has one in the box that is their blocker number two, but they're going to send out Sharon Misery, Texas Viper, and Daisy Mayhem. D.C. counters with Badass Maggie, Maiden Smackron, Velocity Rapper, and Spank Aaron. So we will see. As you can see, we talked about this, Stunt Rocker. D.C. did well when they could get their wall at the back. And look how they've lined up on the Zombie Burger Jammer line. Where are they at? They're at the back.
That's right. They're going to, you know, they're going to get out there, and they're going to try and slow it down, keep the pack slow. They're going to keep their wall tight, keep the jammer behind them, whereas Omaha is going to want to speed it up, get things a little more spread out, get a little chaos going, and then they'll do very well at just positionally blocking is what they've been doing.
I'll tell you what, if body language is any indication, just my observation, my armchair psychologist, Omaha seems pretty excited. They're up. They're really
up,
energetic.
They're loose. They're ready to go. Yesterday, I think they might have come in, and maybe they just were a little too overconfident. Yeah. This is the Division II. We're coming down to the Division II, and we can, you know, handle all these.
Oh, almost the inside line was available for Skateaway Faye, but she gets edged out at the last possible second, has to recycle back behind the three-woman wall. So DC's got what they want. They got the setup they like defensively. Jammer pushes forward Lenore Gore, and she's able to get lead jam. So this is currently the formula for success for DC.
Yes. Skateaway Faye just getting stuck there in the back. Then bringing her up to the line.
Lenore Gore hops, skips, jumps, but doesn't do so illegally. It is a track cut. Oh, my. It looked, everything was running so well for DC. They had everything they wanted, and they lost a jammer once again.
Skateaway Faye now on the power jam.
Skateaway Faye is probably not content just to get out.
Not enjoying that full turn.
But you can see Omaha, they've got a blocker back there. They've got Spank Aaron they're holding on to, and they've just actually edged her out.
And now
that was the blocker. It looked like she made an out-of-play hit there for DC. So Skateaway Faye does get her initial pass done. That was Maiden Smackron that was sent to the box for the out-of-play hit. DC is fighting hard. Omaha is set up in the passive. They're not going to move. Tempo to the by the pivot to bridge. Can't do so for DC. So 5 points going to the board for Omaha, and Omaha will extend their lead.
Omaha playing that side offense, the passive offense, the sausaging very perfectly, just sort of keeping an eye out. Mm-hmm. If they get too far back, they'll block out and make an opening for Faye. If not, they'll just let her push the pack forward.
Skateaway Faye does get 5 more points to the board, but the power jam comes to an end, and Lenore Gore fires herself out very quickly. She gets 5 points off the bench, trying to limit the damage. This one's going to go the full distance. This one's got about 12 seconds left in the jam. Skateaway Faye tries to get up to the top of the pack, but look at Lenore Gore. Speed Demon gets her way inside, untouched. 4 points for DC. Badass Maggie sends out Skateaway Faye. She wants the track cut. She may be getting it here. We could have a power jam start here for DC.
I think that the question comes down to was Had the whistle been blown or not?
They are talking about putting her in the bench. Right now, only one jammer out there, and that's DC's jammer. And that is Jersey Jill.
And Skateaway Faye is headed to the penalty box.
That's right. So we have ourselves a power jam for DC. DC now down only by five. Omaha was able to get some points. We're going to have, it looks like, an official's timeout, I believe.
That's a perfect time to thank DerbyForAll.com.
Team timeout for Omaha. Go ahead. Derby.com. Go ahead.
DerbyForAll.com. Experienced skaters getting you the right gear you need to take you to the next level. I know Derby for All is the official skate tech of the tournament. Dirty Larry, my teammate, sitting down there at the sideline.
So he's prepared to fix any skates whenever
needed. I can personally attest, yes, Dirty Larry can fix pretty much any skates. He can build you any skates. He could probably make a skate if he wanted to.
This was a team timeout, but I do believe that there is an explanation going on, is my suspicion about what took place. And you talked about it briefly. We touched on it. I did see the track cut. That was my own vision. I think you saw it as well. But the question was, where was it? Fourth whistle, after the fourth whistle, before the fourth whistle, excuse me. And so they're going to probably try to figure this out. And this is big. We are looking at 5 minutes to go in the first half,
exactly.
Sunrocker. Five-point bout, back and forth. Seems like a pretty even matchup skill-wise. So this power jam is huge. And if Omaha can get this turned around or discussed, then I think they're going to love to see the results.
I'm sure that Omaha is arguing that he'd blown the whistle. You can't have a track cut when there's no play.
There's no play.
Whereas DC is going to possibly say no.
She cut. Well, I believe it was Badass Maggie who edged her out and forced that cut. Skateaway Faye looked like she was pretty fatigued on that jam. She had to go the full 2 minutes, so she just kind of sort of lunged herself back in.
And I am going to say that whatever the refs said,
they're in charge.
What the refs said. This is a great ref crew we've got out here.
It really is.
And they know it better than I do.
So the timeout that Omaha took had transformed itself into an official's timeout.
Now we are into official review. Now you can see that right down on the feed, right below the WFTA TV logo.
Yes.
You see, it used to say team timeout. Now it says review.
That's right. So five-point difference here, 5 minutes left to go, and it looks like the call is going to stand. Only one jammer out there, and that is Jersey Jill. Omaha will send out Forbidden Fruit. They will send out Axel Rogue, Mickey Killia, Denalia Coffin to try to stop this power jam. For DC, they've only got two blockers out there right now, so they're going to have some work to do.
We have an official explanation of what happened in that review.
I cannot wait
to hand it to Double H.
We're going to go to our sideline reporter, Double H.
All right, thanks, guys. So you were indeed right. It was a clarification on that cut. Omaha, of course, was asking about that. The skater that Omaha's jammer cut, however, was not the one that stepped out of bounds, as they had claimed. It was a different red skater, so indeed that track cut does stand.
And we are back to action here. Thank you so much, Double H, for the sideline reporting. That is quality work, number 85. Jersey Jill does get lead jam, and this is going to go around for her first scoring pass. Omaha still has all their blockers. Well, I'll take that back. They are losing a blocker. So they're going to be down to three. Forbidden Fruit will sit down for Omaha. Nice job. They're slowing this one down, and you know how they're doing it? They're doing it with speed. You talked about it early, Stunt Rocker. They're moving quick today.
This is a packs are moving fast. I'm enjoying it. I think everybody enjoys a little bit of fast.
We do, especially this morning. We got to wake up.
Yeah.
5 points on the board, though, so we have ourselves a tie bout, 68-68. Potential chance for a lead change here if this scoring pass can be completed by Jersey Jill, and it does. Five more points to Grand Slam, and DC has come back and taken the lead back from Omaha. Power jam is over. Skateaway Faye is back out on the track and is able to get herself free. The DC blockers.
Take a sip of your coffee for that lead change.
Yes, it's a coffee sip.
Didn't say we had to have a dope every
game. It might be too early for that, just maybe. Jam has called off 2 additional points on the board for DC, so DC storms back and now takes the lead over Omaha. We have ourselves a back and forth effort here from both squads.
Listen, if you want to tell us what morning beverage you're enjoying this fine game with, you can go do that at the hashtag talk2wftda.com and pretty much use that on any of the social network services. We'll find it, we'll get it, and we'll see what you said.
A Lining up on the Zombie Burger Jam line is Frightmare for DC against Radio Ruck for Omaha. DC is down one blocker. And it's Forbidden Fruit. She sits in the penalty box right now. Oh, excuse me, that's not Forbidden Fruit. That's the wrong team. I'm making stuff up. Either way, she's back out. Lead jam goes to DC's Frightmare. So DC responds again. We've seen this, the reaction and response from both squads. They're able to adapt quickly. Packet slowed down so much, though, that Frightmare's back around. Radio Ruck finally gets clear. Scoring pass on the board here for DC.
Texas Viper headed to the penalty box on that last jam.
4 points for DC on that one. They will extend the lead now. 79-68. About 2 minutes left to go. This one's had everything we've hoped for. This is exactly what you want. You want to see these consolation bouts, a close, tight battle. There's a lot to play for. We talk about 2014 in terms of rankings and point differential for next season. But more importantly, don't go in a tournament and come away without winning something, right?
Yeah, you got to win something. Just you're really only playing for pride in anything. Actually, they're playing for a spot in the next game.
Lenore Gore is playing for keeps as she pounces off the line, finds an open space there between Omaha blockers and gets lead jam with lightning speed and is back around very quickly. Quick skater uses her speed to her advantage to get momentum, goes on the inside and gets a quick scoring pass as Omaha's jammer gets sent back and recycled. 5 points to the board already for DC, and we've seen DC have this ability to take over at times. They just can't play clean enough to make it consistent. Lenore Gore back through again. This is a lightning strike. 10 points.
Lenore Gore just showing a surprising amount of power for. She's a thin frame.
Oh, inside. Tightrope walk. 5 more points. Omaha is having some issues. Make it rain. Cannot get free. Finally does. But already 15 points on the board. Is this even strength jam is going all ladies in red? President of the United States is happy. His team is doing well. You know they're from Washington, D.C., right?
Yes, I do.
Okay, I didn't know if you knew that. 3 more points to the board for D.C. So that is an 18-point jam. Holy moly, even strength. You got to love it if you're a fan of the Ladies in Red this morning. And if you're Omaha, it's time for the timeout.
Exactly.
You don't get any bonus points for keeping the timeouts. You got to use them.
No, there's no reason not to.
That's right. So with 49 seconds left to go in this first half, Omaha looks to try to have a nice positive ending. They're down right now 97-68. DC has given some and taken some, but they have been able to really overall get the bigger runs in their hand, and that's why they have a little bit of lead here going into the half that they're trying to hold on to.
Both teams kind of streaky in this game.
Yes, they are. Yes. We've seen that this weekend in several different bouts. We saw this actually in DC's bout against Jet City. You saw some streaking going on. I don't mean the other kind of streaking. I mean the point streaking.
Yes.
Keep your mind out of the gutter, Sun Rocker.
That's what I was talking about.
All right, good. We talked about streaky. Well, you know, looking at the penalties on the board, pretty even. You know, nothing really stands out to me. I think that really the timeliness of the jammer penalties for DC has been the big problem. Sharp Shredder will take the jam line for DC. She wears 606. She will be using the blockers, Badass Maggie, Akutra Payne, Velocity Raptor, and Jersey Jill. Jersey Jill doing double duty here today. Number 39, Midlife Crisis, will be jamming for Omaha. Forbidden Fruit, Mickey Killia, and Denalia Coffin. But DC comes out strong once again. Lead jam off a very quick start.
DC just able to push through that wall.
Setting up at the back. They love that, my friend. That's the way they've been successful this bout.
And it causes Omaha to get so far off of them that they go out of play and they have to let her go.
Scoring pass to the board already. 5 points to the board. Midlife Crisis is able to get out, so that's good news for Omaha. But Sharp Shredder says, I've seen enough. I'm going to get my 9 points. I'm going to call this one off. And there is just seconds left here on the period clock. We will see if they have time to line up and get one more off. Either team appears content to call a timeout.
Nope, that is going to take us to halftime.
And it will be a halftime score from DC 106, Omaha 68. Good stuff. They are back and forth, tight, tight action. Both squads getting nice chances to go on runs. Both squads very physical. We see that when DC can line up at the back of the pack with their four-woman wall or the three-wall, whichever they can do, they seem to do very well. Omaha seems to like going fast this morning.
Yeah, Omaha just wants to get out there and burn up the track. And when they do, they are having – They're having really good luck in getting scores, getting the score up there. But when the pack starts to slow down, and you have to keep those tight walls, it gets a little. They're getting a little loose.
Yep.
They're getting a little separated, and they're getting through.
It's nice to see the contrasting styles in the battle that goes on. We will be taking a brief break here, my friend. Got a little halftime show. We've got some confusion from our production team. She's trying to throw us off here, trying to test us. So take a brief break. We'll be back for second half action between Omaha and D.C.
Okay.
Hold on.
Hey, Omaha. Most of you already know me, but my name is Malai, and I'm the founder of the Des Moines Derby Dames, and we are super excited to have you guys at our tournament. I will be your wrangler for the weekend. So call me, text me at any time. I will be there when you're practicing, when you're playing. Whatever you guys need, I'm your woman.
Hi, DC Roller Girls. I'm AJ Dupretty with Des Moines Derby Dames, and we are very excited for you to come to Des Moines. We're looking forward to meeting you. I hope you're ready with your party pants on. Oh, and you might want to be ready to play, too. We'll see you when you see ya. Get ready, get pumped, because I am.
Hey, this is Dan from S1 Helmets. We're here at the Angel City Derby Girls practice facility, hanging out and watching them practice. A few years back, we noticed that a lot of girls playing roller derby were not wearing certified helmets. They were wearing non-certified sock foam helmets, and we were concerned. We've been trying to get the word out to everyone that plays roller derby to wear a helmet that is certified for multiple and single impacts. While we were here, Octane Jane was jamming, and she got hit, snapped her head back, and hit her head pretty hard. Octane Jane was fine. That's why we want girls in certified helmets, dual certified helmets, because you can't control how you fall in roller derby. It's a contact sport. You're going to get hit, and you're going to go down. And this happens all the time, all around the world. And if you're in the wrong helmet, you're really going to hurt yourself. And she was wearing a Lifer helmet, which is dual certified, and she got up, and she's fine. So we're stoked, and the helmet worked, and that's what this is all about.
We are back here. Second half action. First bout of the day of day two of the Division II tournament here in Des Moines. We're joined here by our friends from Herbalife, keeping us going. The official
Herbalife
energy drink for the sponsor, the announcers of this bout. This tournament. Gosh, it's everybody. Great bout so far. 106 for DC, 68 to Omaha. We've seen contrast in styles and effort. We've seen a little bit of everything. Both squads given a lot of energy this morning for a 10 a.m. bout.
Nice ping-ponging back and forth of the scores. Excellent bout.
We are talk penalties. Always talk about penalties. It's just part of the deal. Pretty even. Both sides really about within one of each other. Looks like Omaha's got about 16 unofficially. DC 15. Yesterday, DC had 10 jammer penalties, which caused trips to the box and caused power jams for the opposition. Today they've got 4. So even though they don't have a huge amount of penalty problems overall as a team, nobody's really going to have any issues. We've got a couple with 3. Daisy Mayhem and Danielia Coffin for Omaha have 3 penalties. Everybody else has got 2 or 1 for both squads. No one's going to fall out of this one unless they really get crazy.
You know, and knowing Omaha a little better than mm-hmm. D.C. as I do, 3 penalties for Daisy Mayhem or Danielia Coffin, mm-hmm. that's actually not bad for them. That's actually pretty par for the course, pretty normal. They're not.
Hey, you're going to get physical, right?
They both are very physical players.
Yeah.
They incur a lot of penalties.
It's just part of what happens when you get out there bruising around.
Exactly.
So really, from that situation, we've got nothing going on. Scoring's been pretty equal across the board. It's been a pretty even bout, and that really is the story of this one, and that's what's so enjoyable about it. It's been interesting and fairly equal. So.
It's anybody's game, just like it's been anybody's tournament so far this weekend in Des Moines.
Yeah, we're going to talk about that a little bit later. We're going to have a semifinal action this afternoon, this evening at 4 o'clock and 6.
Yes.
And we're going to have ourselves quite some interesting matchups there, as we're going to see Blue Ridge versus Treasure Valley, and we're going to see Jet City versus Sin City.
Treasure Valley, who's sort of become the darling of the tournament.
Yes.
Every tournament sort of has one.
Yes. And I wanted to be the darling of the tournament.
I always wanted to be.
But it didn't work out. So it's Treasure Valley. So we are going to get ready to go back to action here very shortly. Sun Rocker's stunned at that comment. He's not quite sure what to say about it.
So. I'm just thinking, for some reason, of you doing a haka like the New Zealand team did in the World Cup.
Yes. Skate Away Fade will be the first jammer here for Omaha as the skaters go to the, what is that? The pivot line?
The pivot line.
Yes. And the first jammer here for DC is Jersey Jill, number 85. DC, if you're just checking in, is in red.
Jersey Jill shrugging off a big hit at the end.
Yeah, she gets lead jam, and Omaha will be in the olive and black. I'm calling it olive. Oh, it's like the pivot took a big hit, maybe a shoulder injury there for DC, and she is really hurting. Jersey Jill on her first scoring pass still going on. I got to give it to DC's pivot. I think that is badass Maggie out there. She got hurt and still out there playing. Anyway, Faye has gotten out, though, and Jersey Jill's content to call the jam off.
Badass Maggie, well-named.
Yeah, she is definitely well-named. She, it looks like she did something to her shoulder. Hope
holding
she's okay.
Holding her shoulder as if it's hurt, and
yeah.
Still going for big hit,
and was,
for a hit
yeah,
wherever she can.
Exactly. So, I'm sorry, we got caught up in that. That was a three-point jam there, I believe, for Jersey Jill. And as the skaters prepare to line up once again at the Zombie Burger Jam line. That is Frightmare for DC in red. And that is Make It Rain for Omaha.
Make It Rain looking for the inside.
Both squads down two blockers, so this is a little couple skate. And Make It Rain says, take me to the dance. I'm lead jammer.
She goes through.
Frightmare is closely behind her. Frightmare's picking up speed, actually. She's catching track.
Frightmare actually just sort of followed the same hole that Make It Rain pushed through.
Omaha gets a third blocker back. DC, though, Whips and Pains and Dual Hiddison are really setting the pace, and they're keeping their distance
the
away. No points at all there for DC.
Was not able to get her hips around.
And no points for Omaha. So that was a lot of flash and bash for nothing. Zeros on the board. Nope.
Particularly disappointing for Omaha because DC has a full penalty box now, and that would have made that just one skater would have given her the points for them.
Yeah, Ghost Point would have been nice to pick up there. Ready Ruck out there for Omaha and Olive. Lenore Gore, the speedy one, the wily one for DC. And lead jam goes to Ready Ruck of Omaha, just physically overpowered it turns out to be the lone blocker at that point for DC.
And that one-on-one is not always...
That's a workout. No fun. Nobody likes that one. Reinforcements coming in for DC as they try to slow down Rady Ruck. She's on her first scoring pass. Lenore Gore does get out past Omaha's blockers. And Rady Ruck is content to call the jam off. Gets two additional points.
Oh, that was three.
3 points. Additional point goes on the board. Penalty being assessed right at the end there by Maiden Smackron. It's like an illegal use of the forearms. So she will sit down. DC's penalties already kind of creeping up a little
starting
bit here.
To creep up on us.
Creeping, they're creeping. Taking the jam line for Omaha. Midlife crashes.
Maiden Smackron already got up to grabbing her fourth foul.
Very quickly. Yeah, Jersey Jill out there for DC. Jersey Jill thinks inside's the way to go. Can't find it there, so both skaters pinballing back and forth behind these two walls that are kind of interchanged right now. They're sort of interacting.
Daisy Mayhem goes for a big hit.
And ends up being a lead jam there for DC. Jersey Jill is the one to fight her way through, but Midlife Crashes makes it. About a quarter of a length lead here does Jersey Jill have, and she is trying to get back up. Omaha trying to set the pace, get the pack to move very quickly. Jersey Jill finds the inside hole. Calls the jam off, and they're going to give an illegal procedure penalty to Jersey Jill, and I think we might have ourselves a power jam here to start. First power jam of the second half for Omaha.
Spot what she did to earn that.
It was
looking down at a piece of paper.
I believe she called the jam off and initiated a hit at the same time while pulling the jam off. So perhaps. That was perhaps it. I'm just speculating. I had a confused look on my face for my partner,
so
they don't know.
So hard. But also, we'd like to thank our sponsors, PrintCo, PrintCoGraphics.com. For all of your printing needs, hit up PrintCoGraphics.com.
Well, Skateaway Faye, who woke up this morning and had her Herbalife and her Wheaties, gets lead jam as she is the lone jammer on the power jam. She's going to try to fight her way past DC's blockers. The pivot for DC, Badass Maggie, who looked like she hurt her shoulders. Well, she's out there again. She doesn't even care. 5 points to the board for Omaha. It looks like Sharp Shredder will take a seat to the box. She will join her jammer over there, and that is the Notorious R.E.D. penalty box. A 5-point outside run there by Omaha. The Omaha fans go crazy. 10-point jam.
Wonderful screen block by Omaha to open up a lane for Skateaway Faye. And Skateaway Faye shugs off some big hits and got one to beat.
Good awareness by Skateaway Faye. Skateaway Faye almost got the complete, complete moves. She does get the five, yeah. Maiden smack one slowed her down, but looked like Skateaway Faye looked at the box, saw that the jammer in the penalty box, Jersey Jill, was standing, so she figured, okay, let's start the next jam off with a little advantage here.
Very smart. I don't know how many times I've seen jammers just completely unaware of where the opposite team's jammer is in relation to the box.
I tell you what, that has been a big thing with New Derby, jammer awareness. How they've gotten better at that, how they're growing at that has been so important. 4-0-2 out there. That is the jammer for Omaha. Make it rain. There she is, lead jam for Omaha. Plenty of time on that brief power jam to get the lead jam. Jersey Jill out of the box. She's able to fight her way through. Takes advantage of the only two blockers out there right now, riding dirty. Tries to join her teammate. Whips and pains. 5 points on the board for Omaha. They're able to complete the Grand Slam pass. No points on the board for DC. So DC down here at halftime. DC up at halftime, Omaha down, and Omaha decides they're going to go ahead and try to come back.
Omaha mounting a comeback. Yes. They still got a little bit to go, but they're pushing.
Another, looks like there's going to be a brief pause, or we're going to have a timeout. So we want to hear about some of the great sponsors.
We'd like to thank our sponsors, Crew Skate Shop, www.crewskateshop.com, offering quality-tested derby gear and guidance since 2007. We'd also like to thank Fast Girl Skates, fastgirlskates.com. It's all about you, serving skaters of all shapes and sizes since 2007.
I'd like to thank the folks out in the Twitterverse. They're very helpful. Sometimes announcers, they don't have enough Herbalife in the morning and they mispronounce a skater's name and they sound like buffoons. So I've been sounding like a buffoon. It's Makilia.
Makilia.
Makilia. I can say Makilia. I can do that.
And once you say it, you go, oh, that makes complete sense.
Yes, it's much better than what I was saying.
We'd also like to thank WFTDA.TV. Would also really, really like to thank our lead camera operator, Jimmy, who's been shooting all of this tremendous footage. Jimmy, thank you so much. You're doing an amazing job.
Jimmy's like 25 feet in the air. He's above everyone. He's surveying it all. He's doing an incredible job. The shots you're seeing are all courtesy of Jimmy and the team behind the scenes.
I've worked as a camera operator, and he is fantastic.
So if you have a camera operator in your life, give him a hug. Jimmy will feel that hug from afar.
Or just hug yourself and think of Jimmy.
Now it's getting weird. So we have ourselves an official timeout here. I think there might be some other scoring and technical corrections going on. That's a behind-the-scenes guess. We have a sideline reporter that might be bringing some more information. Regardless, we'll set the table right now.
You know, the D.C. Roller Girls are from our nation's capital.
Yes, they are.
You know what the best nation in the world is?
I don't know.
Donation.
Donation.
Like when you donate, to go to WFTDA.com/passes and just hit the donate button. We're not charging anything for this feed from these Division II tournaments.
Free for you.
So throw a little something in the cup. Help us offset the cost of bringing the cameras, the crew, everything, and bringing this entertainment to you.
Ready Ruck out there for Omaha, jamming against Frightmare for DC. Ready Ruck gets through, but she is not the lead jammer. No pass, no penalty, so she has not gone through cleanly. Frightmare has a chance to get past the four blockers of Omaha. Forbidden Fruit, Makilia, Axel Rogue, and Denalia Coffin.
She's got to get around that. Radio Rex still able to pick up 3 points.
Non-lead jam points, huge, especially when you're down. So that is a great job there. DC does get out, get the lead jam, and call the jam off quickly before the damage is done.
That last official timeout was just refs checking, double-checking the points with the scorekeepers, making sure everything's on the board and everybody gets credit for all the points that they actually accrued.
So I was right. I nailed that one. Boom. Score Magilla. I'm going to shut it down. I won. I'm going on a winner. Lenore Gore jamming out there for DC against number 39, Midlife.
Midlife
crashes.
Just outside lead jam.
Again, being a little opportunistic, being the wily veteran, she just runs through untouched.
Oh, big hit there by Omaha to send the jammer for DC inside.
When Molly Massacre connects,
oh my lord,
it just looks like it hurts.
Lenore Gore is taking a beating, a 5-point Grand Slam, even strength pass here by Omaha, and they have got some physical blocking out there right now, does Omaha.
Well,
they are just pulverizing Lenore. Recycled back. Midlife crashes by DC, so DC is able to extend this pack. Omaha tries to bridge, tries to hold on long enough to keep that jammer. Can't do it in a track cut. It'll be called against Omaha. And she tries to call the jam off, but when you've been called with the track cut, you just can't do that, by the way, Stunt Rocker. So this is a power jam for DC. DC
with the opportunity to pull that lead back out.
Omaha looked so good on that one. They were just beating up the jammer. They were really laying some hits on Lenore. Lenore's trying to fight her way through, gets a little offensive help from Lois Slain, and she's able to get free. So she's got 5 on the board, and this will extend DC's lead. They had been drawn within 16 by Omaha.
Now it looks like DC has picked up a goat. They're going to be able to control that pack in the back.
And right now, the front two skaters for Omaha really can't do much. Lenore Gore goes on a third scoring pass, dodges to the right, gets edged out, but really goes right into the heart of the pivot for Omaha. Daisy Mayhem says, thanks, here's your hit. Lenore Gore has to once again face against those two blockers for Omaha, gets pulverized again, fights way through it, another scoring pass, 5 more on the board. DC's extending this lead. Penalty goes against Midlife crashes, and it was a tough one because Midlife was really doing so well on that jam. Jam comes to a close. It looks like Omaha will get 5 more points, though, Stunt Rocker.
Or DC.
No, Omaha got 5 on that one.
At the very end.
Yeah, and DC got 3, so that will kind of cut the bleeding down just a little bit. And I think Omaha's going to take a timeout, which is a great time to talk about some of the great sponsors that are involved in this wonderful tournament weekend.
I'd like to talk about Fifth Blocker Skates, fifthblockerskates.co.uk, Scotland's first and only brick-and-mortar online derby store. It's Gallus?
It's Gallus, my friend.
Gallus.
Yes, it's Gallus.
Gallus is the Scottish word meaning a wild rascal deserving to be hanged.
Stunt Rocker is Gallus.
I
used it in a sentence.
That would fit.
Right. I can't do a Scottish accent. I apologize. I'm not going to offend anybody on the feed here. That would be embarrassing to myself.
That's all I'm going to do.
All part of it.
That's the most of my Ewan McGregor impression.
That was very good.
We'd also like to thank Sin City Skates there in Las Vegas, SinCityskates.com. We don't sell it if we don't play in it.
That's right. And we will see Sin City later on today, actually. Segue.
Yes.
They are playing a semifinal bout later on this afternoon and this evening. They will be playing Jet City. Jet City looked so impressive yesterday against D.C.
Boy, and that is going to be the top seed, Sin City versus Jet City. That's going to be a fun game.
Yeah, Sin City looked absolutely dominant against Dallas. And we will find out, is it Sin City's that good? Or was Dallas just a little tired from playing about earlier in the day? But we're going to see that battle. And then we're going to see the darlings of the tournament, Treasure Valley against Blue Ridge, and what amounts to be two extremely well-trained, talented, smart teams going head-to-head. Both teams were executing incredibly well yesterday in their bouts. It's going to be a battle between those two squads in the other semifinal.
Pop some popcorn, grab a order a pizza, camp out in front of the TV.
So we have ourselves a continuing timeout here.
Still going.
Skaters are dancing on the zombie burger jam line. Lone jammer out there for DC. Happens to be Jill, so we will see how long she can hold on to this as the power jam, because the jammer Midlife crashes for Omaha stands in the penalty box right now. Omaha with two blockers out there, McKillia and Axel Rogue. Lead Jam goes to DC. Power Jam comes to a close.
Molly Massacre looking to come through like a fullback, but Midlife Crashes just finds a seam. Again, that veteran jamming.
I love to see the jammer come around the turn with a big old grin on her face. That's always a good sign. Having a good time out there. DC's got four skaters out there, though. Jersey Jills approaches the Omaha pack, and great job of Omaha to slow that one down. Non-Lead Jam points out of the penalty box. Midlife Crashes, 2 points on the board.
Boom, she just... Like I said, that opportunistic veteran jamming is so important.
Well, we talked about kind of the positive energy, the positive vibe we felt from Omaha. They seemed to be up. They seemed to be energetic, having a great time. And that kind of moment, that slap into the hands, the yay, I got 2 points, that's exactly what feeds the team.
Roller derby is a game, and games are supposed to be fun.
That's what I hear. Frightmare takes the jam line for DC, goes against 4-0-2. Make it rain for Omaha. Frightmare fights her way quickly, does a little hip, scop, and jump. Lead Jam, DC, excuse me.
Midlife Crashes right on her heels, though.
Yes, she is, right behind her. Omaha's got three blockers out there right now. DC's got all four of their skaters. They're lining up, trying to split things up. But look at Megan Ring goes inside. Once again, non-Lead Jam points, Stun Rocker.
Yes. That actually may be the salvation of Omaha at this point.
3 points for Omaha on that one, only two for DC. So Omaha is saying, go ahead and get Lead Jam. That doesn't bother us in the least. So now it's 132-104, still a tight one, 18 minutes left to go.
Waiting for DC to slip up. You know, maybe they know their penalty proclivities.
Well, yes, it's pretty obvious. It's real. Sharpshooter out there for DC. Looks to the inside, finds the inside physical jammer. Easily shrugs off the hits, gets Lead Jam for DC. Goes up against Skateaway Faye, who still tries to fight her way through the pack. It's a scrum in the middle. She looks to go to the front. Gets edged down by the pivot for DC, and it has to be recycled. Finds the inside. Kind gets hit once again.
Omaha doing something you don't see. It seems to be almost a lost art in derby anymore, which is blocking for your jammer.
Yes. Dual Hiddison was part of the problem there for Skateaway Faye, but she sits down for a directional penalty. And 5 points to the board for Sharpshooter. She's able to get the even strength. Grand slam. Skateaway Faye does get out of the pack finally. But this is the second scoring pass here for DC, and DC's going to try to extend this lead. Playing it calm, playing it cool. Scoring pass for Sharpshooter. 4 points to the board. She looks to the bench, touches her hips, calls the jam off.
We'd like to thank Rydell Skates today for sponsoring this broadcast. Yes. Rydell, the official skate of the WFTDA. Unmatched quality, unmatched performance. You can find them at www.rydellskates.com.
Taking the jam line here for Omaha is Radio Ruck. She'll see the blockers Texas Viper, Daisy Mayhem, and Sharon Misery standing in front of her, going against Jersey Jill for DC.
Jersey Joe trying to go through Daisy Mayhem, which is never a good idea.
Jam Omaha, they're able to react and counter. That's what we've seen. It's been counterpunch after counterpunch from either side. As Omaha gets Lead Jam, three blockers out there. Only two blockers out there for DC right now. And that has definitely limited their ability to slow things down and get their jammer out. As another recycling hit sends the DC jammer back to the back, and we have a scoring pass here for Omaha. Fans love it. 5 points to the board. Grand slam, even strength. Jersey Jill edged out to the inside once again. These three skaters for Omaha, Sharon Misery, Texas Viper, and Daisy Mayhem, are doing a wonderful job. Jersey Jill.
Really brutal line there for Jersey Jill to try and get through. Just not getting any luck.
DC's tightening up, though. They're getting some reinforcements. It's a jailbreak from the notorious RED penalty box. And blockers are coming in red, but oh no, the devil of derby, the track cut, and it's a power jam for Omaha's Randy Ruck. 5 more points on the board and a chance for Omaha to come storming back here. Goodness gracious, it's another run potential for the ladies in olive.
As I said, I think Omaha seems to just be holding back, waiting for their opportunity.
Uh-oh. Track cut, devil of derby. Comes rearing its ugly head with those red horns. And the power jam ends. Randy Ruck sits down.
That is a big missed opportunity.
Big one, for sure. Jersey Jill comes back in and immediately starts battling those Omaha blockers. Once again, low block called against One of the blockers for Omaha. And another power jam flip. Holy moly, it's mass hysteria. Back block called against Jersey Jill. Ready Ruck will be released and hit the pack. She'll pulverize her way through. Bodies flying everywhere.
I think Ready Ruck's limited penalty that she had from the last time that Jersey Jill had been in there had actually run out before she...
Yes, it did. Yes. So what you're saying, Stunt Rocker, is this a full minute, 1 minute going to be probably assessed here to Jersey Jill.
Yes.
3 points on the board for Omaha. We have ourselves a timeout. And it looks like it's going to be a DC team timeout. And why not? Because the wheels sort of kind of fell off there a little bit. DC still in the lead, though, 141 to 117. Bugaboo, yesterday we talked about it. We beat the dead horse. It has been jammer penalties for DC.
All jammer penalties for DC. But also been some jammer penalties have hurt Omaha as well.
Yes, they
well.
Have. They've had some chances to really go for it. I mean, on that last jam, they looked like they could really take control, and they weren't able to do so. Jammer penalty forced this issue to be changed.
We'd like to thank Adam Wheels, adamwheels.com. Adam Wheels, proud partner and official wheel to WFTDA. We'd also like to thank our skate techs and our sponsor, Derby for All, www.derbyforall.com. Experienced skaters getting you the right gear that you need to take it to the next level. As I said, my teammate Dirty Larry over there fixing anybody's skates who has a mechanical issue at this tournament.
That's right. So we'll reset here. The pivot for DC sits in the penalty box, as does the jammer, Jersey Jill. So we will see Omaha take the jam line. They're going to send the veteran. Midlife crashes out there to jam, number 39. DC's blockers out there, Sharp Shredder. And Whips and Pain will try to slow her down. Sharon Misery, Axel Rogue out there right now for Omaha as they have two in the box as well. Quick start on the outside. Lead jam goes to Omaha.
Wow, that was midlife crashes.
Yep.
I've been talking about her veteran jamming and just her track awareness all day.
Are we able to can we call her a wily veteran? Is that okay?
I think that's okay. I've seen her play enough times and in enough different tournaments that I think that's fair.
5 points to the board.
Of course, speaking of veterans, Daisy Mayhem and Texas Viper, two of the blockers have been so effective for when Omaha's been effective today, sitting in the penalty box.
5 more points for Omaha. Power jam comes to a close. Jersey Jill comes out, skates to the inside, and is free of the pack. Pack moving quickly. Goes through turn three. Oh, inside. Smart move there by Midlife Crashes. 4 more on the board, a 14-point power jam, and we now have ourselves another tight one, Stunt Rocker. 10 points to separate these two teams.
That's all it takes. It's a couple power jams, and boom, you're back in it.
Jersey Jill, jammer for DC, picked up a track cut and a back block penalty in the last couple minutes. That now pushes her to 5 overall trips to the box, the notorious RED box. As everybody knows at home, if she goes into the box 7 times, she will be gone from the bout. So that is something to keep an eye on. Keeping an eye on, make it rain, and she gets lead jam very easily for Omaha. Frightmare out there for DC, still has to go past that 4-1 wall, and this is when Omaha just takes care of business. When they have the pack advantage, they are tough to get through.
And that is a big question. That leaves a big question for the coaching over at DC. Do they keep Jersey Jill in the same rotation and just let her keep accruing those penalties? Or do they take her out, let her sit for a while, and try to save her for the very end?
That's right. Well, Frymare is able to get past Omaha, so now Omaha, even though they're bleeding blockers a little bit, they are able to get their jammer through. Jam is called off, 4 points to the board, no points for DC, and now the score gets a little tighter with 12 minutes left to go, 141-135. These two teams just refuse to run and hide from the other side. They like each other too much. They want to keep it close.
Yes, they want to be close to each other, maybe hold hands a little bit.
Yes. Lenore Gore. That's right.
Or just play some
really good, solid, tight derby.
Roller derby.
Lenore Gore will be jamming for DC. Goes up against Skateaway Faye. Only 2 blockers per side. It's a couple skate. And the lead dancer for this one is Lenore Gore, and she will get lead jam for DC. DC continues to react whenever they get down.
Skateaway Faye forced out on the corner, but Sharon Misery coming in and clearing out the blocker that put her out, allowing her to come right back in with nothing but a no pass, no penalty.
Lenore Gore does get the scoring points, 4 points to the board. Skinnerly Faye is unable to get back up to the DC blocker, so no points for Omaha. I think that DC was hoping to maybe bleed a little clock, but it just didn't happen because Skinnerly Faye got out so quickly, because they would have loved to have waited to get more of their blockers out. They did get one more blocker out, so well, they will have the advantage on this jam.
It would have worked if it's not for that big clearing hit by Sharon Misery, just really knocking out the other jammer or the other blocker, taking her out of play, allowing Skateaway Faye to get back on the track right away. We'd like to thank Printco, PrintcoGraphics.com, for all your printing needs. Hit up PrintcoGraphics.com. They can lead the pack with their new UV printing ink.
That sounds exciting.
I know. I wonder if it glows under black light.
I don't think it's like that. I just think it's really, really good.
That'd be neat.
Looks like we have our track gnomes have found a little issue with the track, a little abrasion of some kind, a little breakage of the tape. So the track gnomes are going to address that very quickly. They're on and off.
Keep that safe.
They're like the like an Indy car race when they change the wheels and stuff, or stock car race, like in 2 seconds, zing zing. We just saw that right there.
Green Bay Wacker from the Des Moines Derby Dames out there getting everything fixed.
Ready Ruck will be jamming on this jam for Omaha. Omaha's got two in the box right now, so they're a little outgunned in the pack. And Jersey Jill goes out with the five penalties. Keep an eye on that.
Just gonna let her go.
Let her battle, and she is battling to the front of Omaha. Gets edged a little bit by the pivot for Omaha. McKillia, and that's a penalty, though, so she gets sent to the box. As McKillia, and lead jam goes to Jersey Jill. So right now, Randy Ruck is out there with two blockers and is unable to beat this stout defensive effort by the three blockers for DC. Excuse me, four blockers for DC. They are moving left to right, side to side, laying hits, standing in Randy Ruck's way. Jersey Jill knifes her way through. Says, that's enough of that. I'm going to go ahead and put five on the board. Give me the grand slam. Just when Omaha crawls back in, they get pushed a little further back.
Yes. And DC, every time Omaha starts to creep back up, DC has these streaks of just brilliance where they start to deny them.
Right now, the problem for Omaha, another scoring pass for Jersey Jill in the books, and she gets pulverized there by Omaha. That is a nice recycling hit to send her outside. Tool Hiddison gets caught in behind the Omaha blocking schematic. Body's flying, and that may be multiplayer block. That's good for Omaha because that will send Shredder to the box. Omaha's jammer finally out, but another scoring pass in progress here for Jersey Jill.
Omaha playing a little bit down. We've got two players in the box right now. Mm-hmm. That's not going to help anything when they're trying to hold back somebody like Jersey Jill.
Well, excellent jam there. DC now goes up 160 to 135. We're under 10 minutes to go. We begin to keep a closer eye on the clock and how it gets used and how it gets manipulated. Penalty situation, really don't have any problems at all in Omaha. They've been much more content to spread things across the board. But we do have Jersey Jill, the jammer for DC, who is sitting on five. So we'll keep an eye on her. Frightmare takes the jam line for DC, goes up against number 39. Midlife crashes.
Sharon Misery and Molly Massacre doing a great job of holding her back right there.
DC pushes the front. Tries to get the jammer through. Frightmare's got some issues with McKillia right now. Does finally get out. Not cleanly, though. This is a chance for Midlife Crashes to get lead jam and call this one off before the damage is done. She is given lead jam. She touches her hips. Jam is called off.
Excellent job by Midlife Crashes of ducking under a big hit right there.
The notorious RED penalty box right now filled with some DC skaters. We will see another jam from Jewel Hiddison. Jewel Hiddison, a dual threat here with her squad for DC. She blocks traditionally and has also throws in a jam every so often. She goes up against 4-0-2. Make it rain. Make it rain, physical jammer. Tries to find her way past the front wall and does so. Powers her way through lead jam Omaha.
Excellent job of just pushing through that line.
Recycled is Dual Hiddison, but she's able to fight way past the Omaha blockers there in turn two, and she gets clear. Make it rain. Oh, nice opening move there. Offensive blocking there by number 42 for Omaha. That allows the scoring pass for Omaha. 4 points on the board, and Omaha now down 160 to 139. We're down to the 7.5 minute mark, and Lenore Gore will take the jam line for DC.
Axel Rogue just doing a great job there with that hit. With
yeah,
that
it was. It was
blocking.
A beautiful, like pristine offensive block. And this is going to be Skateaway Fay for Omaha.
And yeah, of course, you can see how Skateaway Fay, Jersey Jill, and all of the girls out there playing right now are doing statistically wise by going to WFT, by looking on your WFTDA.com screen, just hitting the little ringster tab, and then your stats will pop up. You can see all of the statistics that we're using and everyone's looking at.
Lenore Gore gets out of the box. She does not do so cleanly. Lee Jam was awarded to Skateaway Fay, but she was pulverized between turns 3 and 4. No points to the board, so non-Lee Jam points. Bree, go to DC. I tell you what, that's big. Time is running low here, so the comeback's going to have to come sooner than later with about 6 minutes and some change. You're killing clock on that jam, and you're getting points if you're DC, and non-lead jam points are like stealing candy from a baby.
We're down to that point in the game where every single
yes.
point matters.
Every choice matters. Every decision where you block, every decision how you hit a girl, it all is important. Looks like we have ourselves an official's timeout, so with an official timeout, we can officially talk about some of our sponsors, and one of them is Durbalife. Durbalife is the official drink of the announcing corps here of the WFTDA tournament season.
We need a little bit of energy. We drop one of the liftoff tabs in our water and nice little boost. And
you'll see the Durbalife cup, which we have filled with a beautiful energy drink, and we drink it here to keep ourselves up, to bring the excitement to you, the fans
exactly.
at home.
Exactly.
WFTDA.tv is a chance for you to watch this for free, a chance for you to go there / passes, and you can get... You can donate.
You can donate. You can drop us a little change for bringing all of this to you. We, none of the announcers, not us announcers ourselves getting paid. That all goes to defray the cost of putting on this tournament and putting on this broadcast.
And just a little thank you for what you're seeing here.
Another way you can contribute to the WFTDA is to go to the WFTDA.com and advertise on the on the WFTDA.com page. Go to WFTDA.com/sponsors/opportunities, and you can find what it takes to become a sponsor of the WFTDA.
Well, speaking of Frightmare Nightmare, it is Frightmare herself. She gets through so quickly against Omaha and gets lead jam, and I tell you what, now, for a second I thought they were about to call the track cut on Radio Ruck, but they do not. It's a no pass, no penalty. So Radio Ruck's able to get through. Frightmare calls the jam off down from her knees and her back and is able to get 3 points, bleeding clock. Increasing the lead, we now talk about a 166 to 139 lead. Omaha needs to make something happen. They're down under 6 minutes to go. Winner of this bout, we don't know who it's going to be. The winner of this bout will advance, and they will play, as I check the tote board, Omaha will or DC will play Dallas next, and that will be tonight at 6 p.m. So
that should be a fun game.
Yes, it will be.
Teams.
Sharp Shredder out there jamming for DC. Looks like Midlife Crashes, I believe, out there for Omaha.
She's just had a wonderful second half of Derby.
She has. Lead jam. And we've got ourselves the Devil of Derby, the track cut. Oh, if you wanted a move for Omaha, this is the move right here. Sharp Shredder will sit down.
And that's another track cut.
There it is. And it's against
on Midlife Crashes.
Midlife Crashes. Ah, the track cut giveth, the track cut taketh away.
And she was going just around the top of the apex there. One of her feet seemed to slide out of bounds.
That's right. We've got confirmation. The foot slid out, so Sharp Shredder comes back. Pack sitting stagnant right now. Sharp Shredder goes on the inside, and they're going to get the track cut for her again.
Oh, my.
Oh, it is the Devil of Roller Derby. I was just kidding about that. Midlife Crashes back in there very briefly, but she served that brief penalty she had. So this will be
a full minute for Sharp Shredder.
Omaha set up with what they want. They got four blockers out there. They're ready to go.
Just spreading that front pack out.
5 points on the board. There's a partisan crowd here, and they're getting pumped up. They see the potential. Now a 22-point differential.
Omaha just ready to hit. Look at him.
Good job, Omaha. Oh, wow. They blow
excellent.
Up. They blow it up, and they get the hole on the inside. Midlife Crashes hits it quickly. 5 more points.
Excellent job of pushing through and clearing a path for her.
This jam is down to about 20 seconds left to go. You folks can see that on the TV now.
And they do midlife, it once more.
Midlife crashes, fights past one block of the pivot. Badass Maggie can't do it. Can Badass Maggie five more points, a 15-point jam? Holy moly, we got ourselves some drama here this morning. Power jam comes to a close, third scoring pass, only seconds left on the jam clock. Midlife Crash is able to get through. She can get points here. Oh, nice move on the inside, though, by Sharp Shredder. And she's able to get, oh, no points. That was her initial pass. Goodness gracious. 4 points on the board, more points on the board for Omaha. I believe my math would say that it's a 19-point jam. 166 DC, 158 Omaha. It is getting hectic here, folks. 3 minutes left to go, a handful of jams on the board. Oh, me, oh, my.
Exciting.
Sudrock has just got his popcorn out. He's going to eat his popcorn and watch and get excited.
It's a pizza.
Yes. Hope you're enjoying yourself at home, folks. Lenore Gore takes the jam line for DC. Going up against Make It Rain, number 402. Make It Rain, a physical jammer, trying to muscle her way past the DC blockers. Lenore Gore, speedy, fast, agile. Can she find the small space? Does a spin move.
Does.
Lead jam, DC. So this is a big moment here because they can bleed some serious clock, Stunt Rocker. Lenore Gore makes her initial pass, approaches the Omaha wall, Make It Rain, fights her way through, finally gets clear.
Lenore Gore still stuck at the back of that package. She's trying to score. She's just not getting anywhere.
Lenore Gore is content, though, to watch some clock, bleed some clock. Takes a big hit as she's calling the jam off. No points on the board for Omaha. Full 5 points awarded to DC, the grand slam. That is huge.
I think that was just a little love tap.
And that is now a 13-point jam with 1:58 left to go. Plenty of chances to take timeouts for Omaha if they want to control the pack. They can control the pack, get some points, call the jam off, and get another jam in. And they're going to send out Rady Ruck to jam. They'll be going up against Frightmare for DC.
Keep playing their game and sort of trust the hope for DC to slip up.
Well, DC's got two in the box right now. Two in the notorious RED penalty box. Omaha will get lead jam. Rady Ruck controls this pack. Omaha's got four blockers. That's the key. If they can keep those four blockers out there, they can try to hold on.
At this point, every lead jam for Omaha is just huge.
Omaha is going to hold back. Frightmare inside open. Omaha gets the scoring jam, the grand slam, and we're going to have ourselves a star pass. Frightmare
sure
has
are.
Seen enough. Badass Maggie, who's been so tough today, got injured. She's going to get the star. 5 points on the board. It's an 8-point bout. Inside looks good for Rady Ruck again. Five more points to the board. This is a 3-point bout here. Stunt Rockers
are we gonna
having
see?
A stroke to my left.
I know. I'm going to die.
The star pass worked. Star's barely
Sharon
holding on to their helmet.
Almost disrupted that star pass.
Well, and the star pass is barely on the helmet. She might lose that thing. Another scoring pass is Rady Ruck, and this will be a lead change.
That is correct. We have a lead change.
Oh, and we have an injury to boot. Goodness gracious. Badass Maggie was hit there. She had taken the star pass. She was knocked to the inside. We saw earlier in this bout, we saw Badass Maggie took a tough shot to her shoulder, and I believe it could be possible that she re-aggravated that. That's complete speculation on my part, but I tell you what, it wouldn't be surprising to me if she hurt herself earlier and was trying to fight through the pain and got hurt once again.
I couldn't really tell, but it did appear that she was holding that arm or elbow when she went down. That might have just been the way she tucked when she went down. I don't know.
Well, I tell you what, this place was about to explode into a fury. Right now, the scoreboard as it sits would appear to be Omaha in the lead by two. 173 to 171.
41 seconds left in the game.
And so there will be another jam for sure. And boy, with only 2 points, it's really about lead jam. Whoever can get lead jam on this next one will be such a big deal. The EMTs are continuing to take a look at Badass Maggie.
EMT Derek Sweeney there, taking care of her.
They've got her up, and the fans are clapping. She is favoring her leg, so that looks like it was a leg injury. And I tell you what, if ever there was a warrior, if you're a fan of DC and you're at home right now and you love this team, give her a high five and give her a hug next time you see her.
Yeah.
She's been playing, beat up this entire bout. It's been given 100%.
Next DC home game, buy her a beverage of her choice at the after party.
Well, you know, you get that star pass, and it's such a tight moment, and it's a stressful moment, and she didn't care. She fought through it. Jewel Hiddeson takes the jam line for D.C., so she will be the last jammer, ideally, here for D.C. if they get what they want.
Skateaway Faye up there for Omaha.
Omaha fans are standing and cheering.
That's what we'd love to see in this sport.
Two blockers down here for D.C. Look there. There it is, though. Lead jam goes to Jewel Hiddeson. D.C. has a chance down by two to
Skateaway
take control.
Faye takes a whip right between two D.C. blockers.
It's going to be a race against time. All the three blockers are out there right now for Omaha. They're set up. D.C. crashes the wall. Jewel Hiddeson's got one to beat. She does it. But Skateaway Faye's in the pack as well. 4 points on the board. Right now, for D.C., they actually technically have a two-point lead, but Skateaway Faye goes through as well. She's got 4 points on the board. Oh, my. This jam's got a minute 20 left to go. It's going to be a matter of Jewel Hiddeson hitting this pack as blockers are bleeding off for Omaha. Jewel Hiddeson calls it off or tries to call it off. Skateaway Faye's back up there as well. No points on the board for Omaha. 4 points on the board for D.C. Did D.C. do it? The board will score an unofficial final of 179 to 177 for D.C. Referees are going to slow this thing down. Everybody's going to calm down.
Sort of holding our breath until we get that official final.
Referees have skated over to the penalty.
Close to call on that unofficial final.
Right now, D.C., what happened was Jewel Hiddeson got lead jam. She went through her first pass, got her 4 points. Skateaway Faye was free, got her 4 points. So Jewel Hiddeson, with their no time on the period clock, had to get through and call the jam off. It looks like she did just enough to do that. That is what I saw visually, but we have not had an official word from the...
Because if Skateaway Faye happened, if the refs did happen to say that Skateaway Faye did get around one player, just one player from D.C., with the two they had in the box, would give her 3 points, and that would make the difference to tie this game up and send us to overtime.
Another point's been added to Omaha, but that won't be enough. They need another point. Omaha's out there pleading their case.
Okay, I was wrong about the ghost points.
Maybe it was only one ghost point, which they may be giving them, which wasn't enough.
Yes.
But Omaha is asking for more.
We're
still
discussing
it.
I would be too.
I would be too.
I don't know how else to say it. I would be.
D.C. Ruler Girls Omaha, first bout today, this morning, 10 a.m. Everything you ever wanted and more. Stunt Rock is going to need a nap after this one.
Oh, yeah.
I got to do another bout after this. What am I going to do with myself? The winner will face Dallas, and they'll play at 6 p.m. tonight. In the next round of the consolation affair, loser has a tough road. They play tomorrow morning at Sunday at 10 a.m. We don't know who they'll play yet. As this continues to be discussed.
Both teams just literally huddling up.
Oh, this is huge.
The D.C. girls hugging each other.
Yeah. And semifinals, though, today. We're not going to try to distract ourselves from this right now, but Treasure Valley and Blue Ridge will take on each other from the first semifinal at 4 p.m. The second semifinal at 4 p.m. The first one will feature Sin City, the number one seed, against Jet City, the number five. So Blue Ridge was the 3, Treasure Valley the 10. That'll be the 4 o'clock bout. Our next bout here on this track, and you're going to have to good luck following this act, is going to be Duke City and Tallahassee. They sit waiting in the wings.
Who knows, man? That could be even crazier than this game. I don't know how, but it could.
So the referees are going to be really, really cautious on this one. They want to make sure that they have this exactly right.
Make sure it's right.
Because if this does go to overtime, and folks, if you've never seen overtime derby, you want to talk about some stress. No lead jams in overtime. From the first whistle, everybody you pass in the overtime is worth a point. It goes the full 2 minutes.
Bench coach for the Omaha Roller Girls, I'm a fire starter over there. Praying.
Yes.
Going one more point.
There is a voodoo kind of rain dance of points being done over there by Omaha. Referees are all talking about it. This is really important. This affects 2014. This affects the rest of the tournament.
It does. And they got their points.
Omaha wins. Points go on the board for Omaha. There is chaos here.
It's still unofficial.
Still unofficial, though. Right now it shows 182 Omaha, 179. The fans from Omaha have exploded. The music is playing, but it's still not official.
There's tears from the Omaha girls.
What a heartbreaking loss for either team. I don't care who loses this one.
I kind of want them both to win.
Can we have the overtime bout? I'm requesting it.
I'm an announcer, and I'm unbiased. That's why I want them both to win.
Well, incredible.
They both played so well.
Incredible effort from
Tell
both
us what you thought of this bout, yes. this Who? Amazing bout, with the hashtag talk2wftda.com. Use that on Facebook, Instagram.
Yeah, what did you see at home,
Twitter,
fans?
Whatever.
Did you see this final score? Did you see Omaha's points? Tell us what you think. Still
you
unofficial.
You can be completely biased.
Yeah, please do. Is it it? That's it?
That is an official
we
final.
We have an official final. Omaha.
Omaha wins. Wow.
Storming back. Game. Storming back to the very end of this bout with Power Jam. They are given the win. The seventh seed is giddy. The fans are crazed. And they will go on to play Dallas tonight. You will see Omaha-Dallas this evening at 6 o'clock. Incredible, incredible bout to start things off. My adrenaline's outrageously out of control.
Oh, my goodness.
I'm making crazy gestures on the camera and everything. Kudos to DC, though. They played hard today. They had a tough loss yesterday. And they lose an incredible one. And great sportsmanship as Omaha is going over to hug the skaters
yes.
from DC. They know that they just played a great bout, a three-point bout. Omaha comes away. It went down to the last jam. Jewel Hiddison was the jammer for DC. She tried to get through enough times to get the points off. Skateaway Faye was free as well. She added points to the board. We had to wait for their official review. They took a long time. They took their time. They made it final. We're hearing a little bit about what the actual review was about. We'll get what information we can. But, boy, a tough one for DC. They came in as the number four seed, and they now find themselves playing tomorrow morning at 10 a.m. in the bottom half of the consolation bracket. Omaha moves on. They come away with a win. Just a remarkable way to start things off.
And if you notice, I didn't know we didn't have the camera on
yeah.
them, but after the game, the Omaha girls did their victory lap, gave the DC girls all a bunch of big hugs. It was nice.
Yes, it was. And we're going to hear some sideline reporting
I'm
here.
I'm going to hand my headset over
yes.
to Double H so she can explain all the details of what happened right there at the end.
Even though you could see her in the camera, she's on the sideline. Just pretend she's on the sideline.
It's okay. We could have gotten closer, Stun. It's okay. We're buddies. All right. So essentially what I'm being told is that it was not the last pass
oh.
that was responsible for those points being awarded. There was a clerical error
oh.
that actually worked out in Omaha's favor. It was, I believe, for that jam, just not for that pass.
Interesting.
So what they did is they really went back and looked at every point within the last couple of jams, and they figured out there was actually a discrepancy. So it was not, though, that last pass. I know. Are you going to be okay, Stunt? Let me hand you back the mic so you can. I know. We got to get the paddles out for Stunt Rocker's heart.
We will revive Stunt Rocker. What an incredible start to day two. Omaha, all hugs, all tears, all joy. It's not over. This is just the first one.
We
got a long
game.
Day. I'm going to need to take a little breather here because we're about to see Tallahassee and we're about to see Duke City. They're going to try to put on as great a show as this was because they want to advance as well.
And this is what WFTDA playoff roller derby is all about. This is why we watch it.
Division two, it's got the drama, my friend. It's got it.
Division one, division two, it's all playoffs.
For Stunt Rocker, for Double H on the outside here. My name is Magilla Gorilla. It's been a pleasure. Thanks so much. Enjoy the rest of your day, folks. We're going to be taking off here for another bout very shortly.
They told us to just sell skates online. You won't have any overhead. Put some skulls in your advertising. You'll make a mint. That was never our plan. Our plan was to make a store where all day we are fitting skaters, fixing skates, teaching customers, and putting the best gear on their bodies. Before we put 3 W's in front of our name, we made sure we had hundreds of happy customers come through our doors. We're not just Derby owned. We're Derby dedicated. Fast Girl Skates.
Are you tired of slipping through slippery corners? Fed up with slipping on slippery surfaces? Introducing the Villain from Radar Wheels. Stride confidently through corners without slipping out. The Villain digs and holds through the corners like no other. Grips on even the worst surfaces. But don't take our word for it.
I hate sliding out. The Villains were so grippy, I felt like I was totally in control. The wheels are really grippy. They were really grippy, but they were still so fast.
Skater approved. The Villain and Villain Wide by Radar Wheels. Order now.
I've prepared myself for this moment. I have trained hard for this moment. I tell myself, stay focused. Stay calm. See the space. And believe in your blockers. I know I trust my training. Do you? Get some athletics.